This is Harley, and he's the Chief Platform Officer of Shopify. So for those of you who don't use it but have heard of it, I'll give you a little rundown. It's an online retail platform that's used by thousands of small businesses, large businesses, everyone from Gatorade to the Foo Fighters, Beastie Boys, and General Electric, which is, you know, electricity. It's a pretty big company. One thing that's very different about you than probably almost every person in this room is you actually have an MBA.
I have an MBA. I am not an MBA. I want to make that very clear because I do believe that that's very, very different, being an MBA and having an MBA. I'm a lawyer by trade, so I usually tell people I'm a lawyer, but I often do neglect that I'm an MBA. But my background is basically I became an entrepreneur out of necessity. When I was 17 years old, I had two choices, which was either move back home, which was in Florida, or stay in Canada, where I was in school at McGill at the time, stay in Canada and sort of fend for myself. And being naive and definitely stubborn, I decided I would fend for myself. And my first company was a t-shirt company making t-shirts for universities. That was kind of how entrepreneurship started for me. It wasn't out of passion. It was because I had no money and I didn't want to go live in my parents' basement.
So if you had no money, how did you start that business? Because Canada's a pretty large country.
I had a connection to someone who was on McGill, the student council at McGill, and he had told me that McGill spent like $25,000 a semester buying t-shirts for their students. And it turned out that McGill actually spent something like $2.5 million a semester buying t-shirts. I understood the business model behind it. I bought a t-shirt for $3. I printed on it for $1. That made my cost $4. If I can sell it for $8, I knew I was operating on keystone pricing or 100% margins. And so there was a bank that was willing to give me some money. And so I financed the first company with a small business loan.
If it's going well, why did you decide to go get an MBA, and what was the thinking there?
I began to work a lot with lawyers. Every time a t-shirt university gave me a new contract, I had to work with their licensing lawyers. Initially, I was frustrated that I was paying these lawyer fees. And one of my mentors said, look, if you're frustrated with paying these legal fees, and you're also frustrated about, and also you realize that your business isn't necessarily foolproof and people can compete with you, why don't you go and why don't you apply to a law degree? And so I took my LSATs, and there was one university in Canada at the time that had this sort of joint law MBA. And so I just literally checked the box. I thought, hey, this is compelling. I can do a law degree and an MBA in 3.5 years. By 24 years old, I'll be done with this thing.
And how was that helpful to you versus what you had already learned kind of doing your own business?
What the MBA did for me in particular was it formalized certain things for me. Like I knew a little bit of profit margins, but I didn't understand the concept of committed monthly recurring revenue. And I didn't understand the difference between cost of customer acquisition versus customer lifetime value. And just stuff like that that I'm using today to run Shopify was just simply foreign to me. And so the MBA helped me sort of figure out and almost provided me the nomenclature that I use today to run the business. But that being said, I think the problem with MBAs are that they become MBAs. And MBA is mostly case-based, right? They're case studies. And so you sort of assume that you're given a case, you can solve the problem. In the real world, it doesn't really work like that. It's one of the reasons why, you know, MBA has kind of got a bad reputation for a while. But having an MBA and being a lawyer certainly allowed me to be a little bit more knowledgeable and sophisticated.
So if you can't get there and do those degrees, or you don't have the time or the interest, but you want to learn and start educating yourself on some of that stuff, in your opinion, what are some of the best resources that these folks might be able to seek out so they can sort of play catch up?
I actually don't think you need to do an MBA. I don't think any entrepreneur needs to do an MBA. I think if it's available and you get into Wharton or Harvard, go, because you're going to be sitting next to Goldman Sachs' son or something, and I'm sure he's going to help you out later on in life. But other than that, I don't think it's that important. I think there's all this amazing mass collaborative online education courses, MOOC, I think they call them.
MOOCs. No,
right, MOOCs, right.
Yeah.
So I think like that is the future of learning. I'm taking one right now, which is actually, it's product management taught by like head of product at Facebook. And the fact that I can actually take a course on my own time, I do in the evenings, I think that's far more valuable than anything I learned in my MBA. Again, those type of mass online courses weren't available. Coursera's amazing. Khan Academy, K-H-A-N, is amazing. If you're running a software as a service business and you want to understand customer lifetime value and ARP, average revenue per user, and all these things that may seem abstract or complicated, I don't think you got to do an MBA. I think you got to talk to people, develop mentorships, develop mentors, and have that mentorship, and take some free courses.
That's a great note. Let's give it up for Harley.